Welcome students to our class on Savarkar's Hindutva. Before we start with Savarkar's Hindutva, I'd like to mention that before Savarkar's Hindutva, we have already discussed Muslim political thought, especially Sir Syed Ahmed Khan's views on colonialism and modernization, and Muhammad Iqbal's views on nationalism. So while going through this Muslim political thinkers, we have seen the nature of Muslim political thought. We have seen the exclusivity of Muslim identity politics and the demand for separate nation state for Muslims. So we have seen that the nature of Muslim political thought cannot be understood without the link between East, West and Islam. So if this domain of Muslim political thought relates to identity politics, relates to separate demand for nation state, separate demand for Pakistan, then Savarkar's Hindutva, Savarkar's notions, V.D. Savarkar's notions of Hindutva, Hindu Rashtra, basically gives us another dimension of identity politics, another dimension of cultural nationalism, and another domain of territorial nationalism. So if earlier we had discussed the exclusive Muslim political thought, so now we are going to discuss the domain of Hindu nationalist political thought, or better to say Hindu nationalism. So Savarkar's Hindutva is a territorial nationalism, is a concept of territorial nationalism, is a concept of cultural nationalism. Before we start with Savarkar's Hindutva, what do we understand by Hindutva? I will divide this lectures into three halves. First, we will discuss the background in which V.D. Savarkar had developed his concept of Hindutva. Second, I'll discuss the main distinction between Hinduism and Hindutva, the most delicate part of this entire lecture or our thought on Hindutva. And third, we will discuss a few important points of Hindutva. And lastly, we will discuss the relevance of this kind of idea or political notion in today's politics, in today's India's politics, democratic politics. So these are few important areas which we are now going to discuss, right? So Savarkar's Hindutva, what was the background in which he developed the notion of Hindutva, and what is this Hindutva? So the moment we use the term Hindutva, you can understand this is actually related to the term Hindu. And it is also related to the term Hinduism, and it's also related to the term Hindu Rashtra. So these three concepts we will discuss. But let me tell you about the background in which this radical philosophical and political concept was developed by Savarkar. So Savarkar, V.D. Savarkar, he was very much critical or disturbed by the Mughal invasion and later obviously British colonialism. And while he was preparing to join India's nationalist movement, he was very much influenced by the notion called Radical Swaraj. So the fight for independence. So what is this Radical Swaraj? Radical Swaraj is basically related to two of his ideas, social ideas. One, violence is inbuilt in human nature, so we are very much prone to violence. And second, we all are very much prone to changes. And another part of it is there is nothing called absolute moral in politics. So there is nothing called absolute morality. So the morality can change according to circumstances. So Savarkar basically was very much disturbed by these invasions, and he wanted to develop a concept which could give us a ray of hope for Hindu nationalism. So he was very much influenced by Radical Swaraj. he was very much radical by the principle of Swadharma. He was not at all interested in Gandhi's non-violence, you can understand. So that is the reason he decided to join Hindu Mahasabha and wanted to develop his concept of Hindutva. And one thing is very important for us to understand that after the failure of non-cooperation movement in the 1920s, the demand for separate Hindu politics, the demand for separate Hindu Muslim politics, the demand for separate Hindu nationalism, the demand for separate Muslim nationalism, these background became very important. So at the one hand, you have seen the rise of two nation theory, you have seen the rise of demand for separate Pakistan, and at the other, you are now seeing the demand for separate Hindu Rashtra. So in this context, V.D. Savarkar was very much influenced by the notion of Swadharma, very much influenced by the notion of radical Swaraj, very much keen to interpret Sipahi mutiny as the war of independence, and at the same time he glorified the role of Chhatrapati Shivaji as a symbol of Maratha power. So all these concepts basically giving to the rise of a very powerful and aggressive nationalism. So this is the background in which Savarkar developed his notion of Hindutva. But still, I have not come to the notion of what is Hindutva. Please keep this in your mind, that to understand what is Hindutva, you need to know the difference between Hinduism and Hindutva. Hindutva is a political and philosophical ideological construct, which is very much different from Hinduism. What is Hinduism? Hinduism is a way of life. Hinduism is a set of philosophical, religious principles which give meaning to the followers. It's inclusive and it deals with our religious, moral and ethical values. Okay, but Hindutva is not necessarily always religious. Rather, Hindutva deal with the cultural construct. Hindutva deals with the part of history, the part of Indian culture. So it's much more cultural, it's much more historical, it's not always related to religion. So that we need to keep in mind, that Hindutva is much more political and cultural. So Hindutva is a political ideology which had laid the foundation for Hindu Rashtra. What is Hindu Rashtra? Hindu Rashtra symbolizes Hindu community, the homogenized Hindu community, the way in Muslim political thought we dealt with the homogenized Muslim community. Hindutva deals with the notion of homogenized Hindu community. Savarkar continuously mentioned in his Hindutva and Essentials of Hindutva that there may be different types of external differentiations, but internally Hindus can always be consolidated, internally Hindus can always be united culturally and historically and on other grounds. So what you need to keep in mind, that Hindutva is basically can basically defined on the ground of culture, on the ground of territory, and on the ground of jati. So Rashtra, Sanskriti and jati or race. So these are three important components of Hindutva which played very important role to lay the foundation of our cultural and territorial nationalism. So that you need to keep in mind. Okay, another important thing we need to keep in mind, that while describing the urge, the demand for Hindu Rashtra as a symbol of Hindu solidarity, Savarkar continuously mentioned that two concepts. One, the concept of Pitrabhumi. Second, the concept of Punnabhumi. So he mentioned that Muslims and Christians, they shared features, characteristics like Hindus, but the main point of difference was that the Pitrabhumi and the Punnabhumi, fatherland and the holy land, for them it was not Hindustan. So their Punna Bhumi, their fatherland and holy land, Pitra Bhumi, where these were different, and it was not Hindustan. So that was the main point on which the demand for Hindu Rashtra actually was developed. So the background behind Hindutva, the main difference between Hinduism and Hindutva, and the important components that constituted notion of Hindutva, and important elements that constituted the notion of Hindutva, this actually constituted Savarkar's ideas on Hindutva. Now you know very well that this concept of Hindu Rashtra, this concept of Hindutva was taken by the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. And what I can say, we all have seen that since the rise of the BJP, since the 1980s, Indian politics has seen the rise of Hindutva politics, the rise of the demand of Hindu Rashtra. And we have also seen that this kind of ideas, this kind of constructs have always been to a large extent misinterpreted to a large extent. Fundamentalist religious parties, either it's Hindu or Muslim, they have always depended, they have always relied on the selective interpretation of history, selective interpretation of culture. So where you are giving more emphasis on difference and hatred rather interchange and harmony. So that you need to keep in mind, that in our classes we have continuously discussed that how since the 1980s, since the 1990s and recently, these concepts have basically devastating impact on a country like India, where we are marked by the presence of different types of religious minorities and the relationship between Hindus and Muslims, and the rising hate speeches, communal violence, all this actually to some extent owe its origin in our past. So that may be our Hindu past, that may be our Muslim past, that may be our colonial past. So that we need to keep in mind very well. So this is Hindutva. I have already given the references in my Google Classroom. And again, Savarkar's Hindutva was very much part of cultural and territorial nationalism, which helped us to understand the rise of Hindu nationalism. And when today we talk about communal violence, communal politics, you always should keep in mind that these are not the recent events. It has its own history, it has its own past. Thank you. Stay safe. Keep studying.